I am Hidelight of VisionExperts.com. In this video, I'm going to talk mainly about these three awesome devices made by Noise Engineering. These are the Busimilus Iterators, the Manus Iterators, and the Lokilec Iterators per Kido. These things were released somewhere the 14th of May, I'm not sure at this point. But they are pretty new, and I welcome these devices because they fit in the realm of Eurorack designs. And while I'm a really big fan of Eurorack designs myself, I didn't really start working in them just because of the fact that I know once you start going down that path, then your wallet basically drains out itself pretty fast. Just saying, because these things are not cheap if you're going to buy them as hardware components. Just saying over here, these modules are around 300 euro each. The software versions are a whole different story because I bought these on 29 euros each, which is a real bargain. And if you even go for the bundle, you get them even cheaper. So for me, that's already like a win-win situation. The thing is, these things will sound character-wise a little bit similar because it's based on analog gear, meaning you have your sine wave, you have your triangle form, you have your saw wave, and you have your square tone. But the way that these things are handled like is a whole different story compared to like what normal triangle, sine, square, and saw waves are doing, because they do something under the hood where I haven't really pinpointed like what they really are doing, which is really plus sign, because they don't really try to emulate anything that's from the Reason Rack, because it does it in its unique context. That's the beauty behind these devices. That's also one of the reasons why I bought them, because I'm really skeptic about the idea if somebody is going to make another rack extension that is based on the same idea that you have a sine wave, triangle, saw, and a square tone. I have tons of those already, but if somebody's going to make a new one of those, then I have to think twice like before getting them. Yeah, I'm skeptic. I like to be skeptic from time to time, and I welcome these type of things because, like I've said, they do something differently. The way that you could see it like this is that Busimilus is more targeted towards being the percussion element. Well, you can make melodies from them, just saying. Then you have Manus Iterators, which is like a, called almost like your syncing type of waveform type of thing that's taking place. Like you have with Thor, syncing. It does something similar character-wise, but it also has a lot of different differences. Then you have this thing, that's the Lokilec Iteration per Kido, and this thing does a lot with envelopes in particular, and morphing different envelopes and combining all those different techniques combined together. And let's look at feel. This one and that one, that's the Busimilus and the Manus, kind of have a similar workflow, but also they have their differences again. First of all, the Busimilus over here uses a noise oscillator. The Busimilus over here uses a noise oscillator, which can be handled through the attack. Take the attack all the way down. Right click, reset this device right here. Right there. Take the attack all the way down. Press run. You hear that noise generator coming through. I might also warn you, the sounds that I'm producing may not be the best sounds by the human ear. Because we're going to touch the weirdness level a lot. Look at this face. Attack time, meaning you're attacking the noise oscillator, right? So there's that. I'll set the stick to sine. Drop the volume just a little bit, right there. So the more I bring this thing down with like that, I add an additional noise oscillator on top of the sound. But while dropping that more like this direction, the noise kind of goes out of context. It's not even there anymore. But the attack also has a different function, because I can also make a slow slope from this by cranking the attack all the way open like this. Then all of a sudden it doesn't sound that punchy at all. at least this oscillator that is. This goes in conjunction with three different modes. You have skin mode, you have liquid mode, and you have metal. Skin mode is more the normal, natural way of playing a synth. Like you would have a subtractor with a noise oscillator on top of that, and it basically plays like a normal synth. Liquid over here is more the steep pitch up and pitch down effect, like you would normally do with bass drums, for instance. So if I take this thing to liquid, and I would do something like this, and then start dropping down the track over here, there you go already. I can create this bass drum in an instant like that, right? Then you have liquid mode, or then you have metal mode, which is more ideal if you're going to create hi-hats. Right? So, at some extent, the best way to look at it is skin is for making normal sounds. Then you have liquid mode, which also allows to change the pitch rather drastic. And then you have metal mode, which has a more, called metallic type of artifact, which also comes with the harmonics and the spread, of course. Because if I would do it like this, and take the harmonics all the way open like this, spread all the way open like that, then you get that. Combining that with liquid or skin, it's a whole different story, because this context tells me more like it's a straightforward oscillator that's playing with a lot of harmonics on top of it. This, however, turns into more a metallic type of sound, like you can hear right there. And the way that I see it personally is liquid is ideal for making bass drums work like this. There. Then you have the fold knob over here that shapes the drive of the sound itself. Kind of like what you would normally do with a fold distortion, for instance. Then I can duplicate this patch. Let's go in that direction. I'll just do this a little bit fast right now. Like this, like that, like that, like that, like this, like that. Lots of velocity settings over here. Let's turn this into a hi-hat type of setup. There, press run, set the stick to metal, drop the tag, and let's drop the decay. Makes it really short and picky, right there. Because in theory, this controls the noise shape amount and also the oscillator when going past this setting over here, that's halfway there. Then this decay knob will determine the length of the sound in particular. So if I do it all the way down to like this, it becomes more the short, picky type of sound. Doing it more like this, it's kind of like I'm opening up a release on a straightforward ADSR setup. Just saying. So I already have my basic functions already there for making a bass drum and let's say a hi-hat session. I can also try to make this a snare drum thing. Going to go for a more like electronic type of snare. Snare drums usually are generated by a triangle form. But because I also want to have that pitch variation taking place, I'm going to go for liquid instead. And then see how this flows. And then make that a little bit longer. I'm going to drop the tag just a little bit. And I'm going to add some harmonics on the sound over here. Right here. Increase the tag just a little bit more, and I'm going to pitch this up like that. A little bit fold back distortion over there. I'm just going to call this my metallic snare drum, if you will. Like I'm hitting like a metallic pan or something like that. Why not? But I do know that you can create some nice synthetic type of snare drums from this device in particular. So that's a little bit like an introduction about the Basilimus. It's an ideal tool to use to make percussion hits. I like the way that I'm doing it over here. But like I've said before, it's also an option just to play this as a synth. Where we at there. But in that case, I will go for the skin mode instead. And let's play a basic riff. I'm going to go for the D minor or the C minor chord as a basis. Right here. I'm going to throw in a 8-stepper like this, and I'm going to drop it off with. Never mind. I'm going to do it like this. Press one. drop the octave. Make it shorter. And then I can go from square, saw, to triangle. Place with the spread over here. That becomes more like a normal oscillator, right? There. Can also drop the octave with one more. There you go. So basically playing Bassillimus as a straightforward oscillator type of thing. Personally, if you're going to go for the creative route, but that's also my personal recommendation, I would either use the Manus iterators or the Laquilic iterators. Perkidi-co-do-fo-so. Who comes up with these names? Because these things are ideal to reshape sound if you think in terms like I want to have an analog oscillator that plays a melody, but I want to turn that into all kinds of different directions. Well, there are these two over there that basically do such a thing. In the next video, I'm going to talk more about that whole subject. Have lots of fun, and I will talk to you later.